Everyone for staying. All right. So, how's everyone doing tonight? My girlfriend bet me a month of blowjobs I wouldn't come and do this open mic, but I don't have the drawstring or drive to give 30 blowjobs, so I figured I'd better show up. I used to be a wilderness instructor, as you can tell how I look. I'm from the woods. So I work with the at-risk youth out in the woods, or as I like to call them, assholes, because they're fucking assholes. So basically, I stay out in the woods for 8 days straight, live in a tent, and I get 6 days off. That's the drop. And there really is a lot of new challenges to that job. It's an odd job. The first challenge I always have to encounter is like being able to masturbate in a tent without anyone hearing me. It's difficult. It's difficult. Especially if you get caught, then it's really bad. Shopping experience is a little bit different. It's like Bonanza from the old westerns. If you didn't see Bonanza, get with the fucking times. YouTube it. I'm sure it's on YouTube. So they'll be like, hey, look, you're going to town. We're going to send you, you can go to the Walmart, and here's a list of shit for everything you need. So I made a mistake the first time. This is what we did the checkout. It was a construction book, crayons, see, arts and crafts there, candy, girls' underwear, trash bags, and a shovel. Got my panel van and I drove off into the sunset. All I realized until I got back to camp, I should have made that two trips. So these kids, they were there by choice. They were there because either they were sent there by the state or their parents couldn't love them enough and they sent them to us. And they really didn't love there. So one day, they take off running into the wilderness because their goal was to get away from us because they're short-term thinkers, because when they get away from us, they're in the middle of fucking nowhere and they'll probably die. So one day, my co-staff, Paul, was teaching him something about wilderness survival or some shit, and all of a sudden I heard, "We got a runner!" And I was taking a shit at the time, and I was like, oh, I had a decision to make. So I was like, well, I can either finish this because I really need to do this, or I can try and like get my pants up and hold it in and chase after this kid. Well, I did the right thing as they're paying me whole $12 an hour to be a wilderness instructor, so I chased after him. Like, and the beautiful thing is, well, I was chased after him. I passed. It wasn't long into the chase because I can't run really a lot. You can tell. And so we passed two hikers because we're in public property. I'm like, man, I wonder what they're thinking as they see a teenage kid almost look like he's running for his life and a large man trying to put his pants together and run past him. So we come to a standoff on the bridge. And I was like, hey, man, we've run a long ways. We should just go back. It's getting dark because it was late November. And he was like, fuck you, I'm out of here. And he jumped in the river. I'm like, god damn it, I got to jump in after him. And the kid almost drowned. Because I was holding him under the water, fucking asshole. Now I'm a social worker in St. Paul because I get shit done, and I work with homeless people, and so it's kind of works because I still look like a home. I kind of look like a homeless person because being a wilderness instructor going over to the working with homeless people looks the same. And the other day I was walking over to the homeless camp, and a man stopped me on the road. He's like, "Hey, where are you coming from?" I'm like, "I'm coming over there from the homeless camp." He's like, "I used to be just like you." What? He's like, yeah, I struggled with addiction for a long time. I'm not fucking homeless. I mean, they're homeless. I mean, I smoke weed and drink with them, but I'm not fucking homeless. What was I going to say? Forgot the rest of that. Well, there you go. I get my clients drunk and high. That's all you need to know. Where am I at, Ski? How am I doing for time?
4 minutes and 24
Jesus
seconds.
Christ! I was hoping you'd say three. Just say three.
3 minutes, yes. Precisely.
Nailed it! Alright, now I get to tell you stories. So, last week, I was here. And this has happened a few times. Because I do understand I'm a large man and I'm bearded and I kind of fit in the bear community even though I'm not gay. That's fine. It's fine. Man approached me and he said, "Excuse me, you're beautiful." I was like, "Well, thanks for noticing." The thing is, though, this guy, I mean, like, if I were gay, this guy was hot. I mean, like, he was a good-looking dude. Like, he looked like the dude that all my ex-girlfriends with, or, excuse me, sorry, all the girls that I like end up dating instead of me. And I'm like, man, maybe I should be gay and beat him to the punch. Like, I got him. Fucking got him. I'm the pretty girl in the bar today. I don't think there's any women left, but I pointed one. I'm like, you and me are on the same level. I totally get it now. All right. There's no women here, though, I don't think. There's a woman here, sound off. No? Okay. Good.
Silence.
Silence. No girls. Now, I'm going to tell you a little story. I don't really know how to make this into a joke. It's kind of funny in itself. So I'm going to tell you, we're going back to 2009. 2009, August 2009. Black Eyed Peas, I Got a Feeling was the number one song at the time. I know that, because I had a feeling myself. That feeling was freedom. And I joined the Army at the time, because I just got done with a semester's worth of college classes. It was my senior year, and I failed all of them. And my girlfriend left me for my ex-roommate. So things were going great. And so, you guys have saw, you know, war movies and basic training. You know what that's like. They just yell at you and make you do a bunch of stupid shit. So we'll get through all that. Okay, so then and I was a medic. I was a medic. I went to a recruiter. I'm like, excuse me, what is the, you know, can I be, like, what should I do? And he's like, well, we have a thing for medics. I'm like, what do they do? He's like, well, you know, they're heroes. I'm like, cool, I want to be a hero. And I said, and he shot me straight. He's like, it was 2009, and unbeknownst to most of society, there was actually two wars going on at the time. So I was like, all right, cool. I can do that. Like, travel, see the world, punch my passport. I was like, they don't really punch your passport. I'm like, well, I'll go there. There'll be pictures. He said, you'll probably go to Afghanistan. I'm like, what's that like? He's like, well, it's like Colorado. I'm like, all right, cool. And he said, they shoot at you. Oh, cool. And so I went to medic college for like 3 months, and then I said, you're good, man, you can work on anyone. I'm like, this is kind of scary. Most people who like start cutting people open have at least 6 years of experience. Well, anyway, so show up. The first patient showed up. I met Captain Maribel Andrade, or as I like to call her, Captain Bitch. I don't call her that to her face, that'd be stupid, that'd be really bad. We're good friends now, but that, when I first met her, she was a real asshole. First guy comes in, I was a medic, she's like, this guy has lower back pain, all right? And I need you to go through these tests that I can't remember anymore, because it was 2010, and fuck, I drank a lot since then. And she's like, I also need to check him for tone. And I'm like, tone? What's that? She's like, I didn't remember that in medic college. And she's like, well, you're going to take advantage of that on-the-job training the Army promised you. I'm going to teach you how to do it. I'm like, sweet. She's like, I need you to get a glove. Put it in your hand. I'm like, got it. I need you to take your index finger, pointer finger, not your index finger, your pointer finger. I know what I'm doing. And I need you to stick it in his rectum. I'm like, what? And he said, what? And I was like, yeah. And I need you to stick it in his rectum and have him like squeeze his butt together, make sure his muscles still work. I'm like, you want me to finger bang this guy? She's like, yeah. I'm like, okay. Oh, here we go. I finger banged a guy on the first day of my job. All right, I don't know how many guys have finger banged dudes on your first day. It's weird. Especially when you're at the bar later that week and they think they bonded with you and they're like, hey man, what's up? I'm like, get the fuck out of here. I'm just trying to forget all this happened. Some of you won't get this. It's okay. So that actually happened. Not even lying. Next, I have one more. I'm sorry, I'm probably going way over. I'm last. It's all right. I'm sorry. Thanks for staying, everyone. Anyway, so my first procedure, that was my first patient. My first procedure was, it was actually a guy from Minnesota, believe it or not. I grew up in Wisconsin, and I had barely been to Minnesota when I was growing up. And the guy came in, I was so excited. Because a lot of people in the Midwest get excited when they see someone else in the Midwest. Like, hey, you got out. It's great. Isn't it? It's great, right? I was like, hey, you're from Minnesota, and I'm from Wisconsin, we're in the same area. And he was like, I don't give a fuck. All right, cool. All right, so he walked in, and Captain Bitch was like, all right, here's the deal. This guy has a cyst. I'm like, okay. I need you to IND it. I'm like, all right. IND is a medical term for cut open. They just don't use cut open, they IND it. And she's like, all right, it's in his ass. What? And she's like, yeah, I need you to cut this cyst open in his ass. I'm like, all right. Because I was game. I was like, all right, I'm here. I signed this stupid paper. I'm here. I got to do whatever they tell me to. So here's the deal. It was really awkward for me and him. And I was like, I'm holding his cheeks open, right? And Captain Bitch doesn't always say eating yogurt, which is weird. But she had Latina pride. She brought it. And,
What?
Yeah. She was Andrade. She was from Mexico. She was from Los Angeles. Or as they say in Spanish, Los Angeles.
Yogurt, though?
Yeah, yogurt. I'm not even fucking kidding you. Yeah. She was just like, whatever. I got this. She's like, I fucking, whatever, man. Pussy, let's cut this cyst open. I'm like, okay. I'm not even kidding. And I'm holding his cheeks open. I get about this far from it. And I throw up on his ass. I throw up all over his ass. I basically did to him for free what you had to pay $500 to a prostitute to do. And that's kind of like turning your ankle in gym class for the mile. Like, I can't run the mile. I turn my ankle, and they're just like, no, you're going to cut that thing open. You're going to clean them up and cut them open. Yeah. And I'll never forget that asshole from Minnesota. Thank you, everyone. My name is Luke B., and that's my time.